you think you tricked them? When you can't see your bloody bewitched forest for the bloody withering trees!
Creator, Mwari, Magna, Merkes, Widebator. A great reward in itself. Just to stir things up. Why then a peckish leech that sucks till glutted? I think not. My lifeblood is drawn from you alone. I can never be sated. It was time to give you to those who doubt your vital spark, who claim you do not, cannot exist. Let them pour the charlatan's bantling and you may bleed on them. Then the claims, then the ridiculous claims of the association that you exist in my mind alone will be fouled and cleansed in one stroke. Another well-meant blow, I shall weave my way under their skin as if quietly mustering with them, the United Association of Instrument Makers in the Rue Serpente. So, all the masters of this sharp art of trumpet-making in France see me as an evil to be quashed, do they? Do they laugh? Huddle in quorum under the guise of a friendly society, they plot to cripple me in the courtroom to defame and destroy. Can the association prevent my patent? Steal away my saxophone? Am I to be husked and trampled, my name devalued, my life of no worth? No. 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 They dare to claim she wasn't my invention. They'll have the proof. They threaten and buy off my workers, bribe them to spy, steal my plans, wreck my machines, burn, shred, splinter, and then be upstanding, and our evidence, Maître Duclos, and the timbers of French justice warp and tumble neath the sobbing of their hunted lies.
Adolphe Saxe.
Eh?
Raoul, Hallery, Goutreau, Bouffet, and Gambras, being instrument makers of high moral standards, charge you with the making of false claims.
What are you saying?
The Saxe system is a lie.
I will have a patent.
Article 31, your claim is dead. The Battle of the Champ de Mars killed your saxophone. The public display prohibits any private patent.
What?
Your instrument had no protection, paraded before all and sundry. It is too late now to provide it with legal cuirass.
No. I have proof.
And now the creature's dissected, it's proved nothing more than a concoction. Viscera, limbs, skin, butchered from foreign stock and stitched together as invention. As creation.
Does not the hawk have wings and the angel? Proportions are all. My saxophone is unique in its tone, its voice, its true proportions. That will be patented.
Sir, your angel has visited many people. A spate of annunciations. Your spawn no longer carries your name alone.
You would copy and steal simply because you envy my fortune?
We steal back because you envied our fortune and sought to diminish it. Why did you give me to them?
They stood there in court and met desperation. They said, after all, you did not exist. You never had existed. You could not exist. And that I was a trickster. So I risked all and proved nothing because they chose to be not only deaf, but blind. They will ruin me, my dear. My hands and your song have brought the protecting walls tumbling down.
What next? I mean, where to now?
Back to the courtroom.
Oh, what?
They say I have no right to call you my own, as too many others already know how you're made.
So?
They also say you do not exist.
Yes?
Well, if you do not exist, what croaking charmers are these who can divine how you work? Ha! Hey!
I suspected my enemies were fools.
But I never dreamed there'd be even bigger fools than I. Eleven. Gentleman in torn clothes, offence and shame awaits.
I say the siren. Three. Lamb to slaughter, boredom and sadness.
Come on, come on, let's see the angel. Six. The helpless drunkard. God! This game becomes more evil by the day.
It always tells the truth. Look, what do you think will become of me?
What? When? Your dice.
8 years in and out of court to win your patent. Less than that remains before I may find myself the plaything of any ham-fisted pimp. And what happens then?
Mm-hmm. Would that I could predict, my dear. Though Berlioz was right when he said it's impossible to misuse you, the accuracy of your tone, the solidity of your sound, my artful contrivance of your majestic nature, all will protect you from musical futilities.
Well, if you'd been able to keep your purse strings tied rather than scattering coins as chicken feed, you might have protected me from...
Never did I throw anything away. All was stolen or cheated
from me. You might have secured a place for me in any of the grand orchestras. I could have been accepted.
The grand orchestras of Bologna and Paris would have accepted you permanently if it hadn't been for the bloody grand musicians who walked out whenever you appeared. Scared off they were, intimidated.
And you were powerless.
Until the Paris Conservatoire gave me some strength. As professor of saxophone, I could inject you into every stage performance imaginable.
But that's it. It's always you that cuts the path I follow. Your friends, your Meyerbeers, Halevis, Rossinis, they all buttress you with a filigree of words when your need is for solid support. And my fear is, when you're gone, what becomes of me then?
It's your play. The association is beaten. You'll at least suffer no more tricks from them. Devil. The devil it is! Ha!
You cheat! You cheated! You slipped the wrong card! That card's been pricked!
Oh, you know me too well. Here, all yours.
Why can't I be in the conceit of some dilettante with both money and manners? Oh! Your habit's contagious, throwing the stuff away. And I found a hidden card, look, in your shoes. Why must you always place winning as... Oh. Adolf?
Yes?
Your tar box isn't under the bed, is it?
No.
Then help me up.
What?
Please, help me.